Currently, we are doing a project that is to enhance access to sexual reproductive health rights and information to young people in Zimbabwe, then Amplify Change as the donor, then and Restless Development as the convener. This project or network comprises of 7 CSOs that is in different parts of Zimbabwe. Advocating for an increase in accessing sexual reproductive health rights, information and services to young people, also including young people living with disabilities.
So what we do is we represent young people, and in representing young people, we make sure that young people's views are expressed. We also make sure that young people encouraged in awareness.
Innovation Zimbabwe creates an environment where one can share, then also one can listen, then at the same time one will be able to make good decision when it comes to decision making. Also, Elevation Zimbabwe influences behavior and attitude through 3 pillars that we are guided by. These are education and training, sports and recreation, advocacy research.
And then we also carried out a research that was checking the service affordability and accessibility in Mutare. And the methodology we used, we did it through one-on-one interviews, and also did 4 key informant interviews. And also we did the one-on-one interviews. We had 198 respondents. In that of 198 respondents, 51% were females and 49% were males. We also did 2 focus group discussions, with one with boys and the other one with girls.
My challenges are ndikusangana nawo ndekuti vamwe vanhu varamba participate kana usina kuvapa mari. Then the other issue iripo when you want to do an interview ne mwana ane disability. It said the parent acharamba kuti mwana yeye aparticipate o munotadza kunatso kunzisana zvakanaka zvekuti nyengwe iye mbereki hatokwanisunge achinzwisa kuti ndezvipi zvamunenge muchitaura nezvazvo. Then zvakanakawo zvatingosangana nazvo ndezvekuti mamwe mayouth ari kuda zvisingaiti kuparticipata, and vamwe vari kutotaura kuti tiri kufanira kunge tichiudzwawo zvakawanda pamusoro pezvatinge tichidini tichiresearcha.
And then we also successfully collected the data, and we discovered that young people are moving with the same notion, or they had the same notion, that the services are not accessible and they are also not affordable in Mutare. And then the other thing we noted is the young people had recommendations for the local leaders and national leaders. The local leaders were said to they should facilitate for improvement in accessibility of services. They should also lobby for a budget that can cover the training or capacitating of youth service providers.
There are interesting things Zanjuksanga Nazo that is helping me understand the social world from my experiences and ingen the children from my youth. So you find out kuti from some youth they are very energetic. They want to be involved in issues that have to do with sexual reproductive health rights, but the problem is they don't have the proper cheap platforms.
We also went through a data analysis process where we as young people analyzed the data that we got from the research. And also what we learned, the process was educative, analyzing data and also validating, meeting with stakeholders and also having dialogues with the district stakeholders. It was an educative process and also interesting.
In Dangampura, we have the challenge, yekuti ma clinics edu mashoma. Plus, kwatinogara kuti tikwanise kuenda futi kuno kune ma clinics pane distance yakakura. So ana tikwanisa kutenga ma kuti tikwanise kundotenga zvimwe zvatichida kukwanisa kuti tibatsirwe.
Uma hospitals still kwatinotopiwa zvino prevent pregnancy like iyo ma pills ma family planning ma protector ma depo ma loop ma jadeo zvakangosana sana but kuti uende ku hospital kwacho unoziiswa kana kuti unotsvaga kana unopiwa unongo kutya kuti okay ku hospital kuno vanhu akona ndivo ndivozoti iyo zerera kwa 16 years uda kuzvidi saka tinotya kuti tiende kuma hospital
hawiri yatinosangana nayo so wakumano pamwe tinotya kunoteswa nekuti mukurarama sewakomana tinenge tichingoshorana munhu akazoita edzi ndinenge takuzoshorana sewakomana kuti uye anenge mwazomona ane edzi kana kuwasikana wedu akazondinzwa ndaane edzi sometimes anogonondiramba saka ndotya kunoteswa nenhau yekuti musikana wangu akazozvinzwa kuti ndaane edzi anokwanisa kundiramba plus kuwakomana kunyaya dzewabereki ndikanotaura kuna wabereki vanogonazondirowa sometimes vanogonazondi vanongonazondi vhundutsira ninhau yekuti vanozondibvunza kuti edzi wakazoiwanepi
Nava information ye SRH ndivana yavaiwane zvakavatohomere vamwe vanokwanisa kuiwana nekuti vakasvika muzvibhadhara sezvo vachigona kuverenga vanogonosvika padesk vodi votora voverenga asi kana paine zvavasinonyatsonzwisisa vakaenda kune manesi ya challenge yekuti manesi havasi sign language vana ivo vasinganzwi vava ndakarerekera hangu nevana vasinganzwi havagoni kuverenga shona vakasvika padesk paine mapepa eshona inekuti information yatorasika asi vakasvika paine english information vanoinzwa kana paine chavasingagoni vadada vabvunze inorasika information nekuti hapana unogona kuvabetsera because vane kwavanomboenda kunonzi kunzeve devsend kune kwavanodzidziswa zvemayouth nevakuru vavarivo saka vanotozoti ndaabhuswa I have to report vanonoreport ndonoupiwa zvinhu zviriko challenge iriko ndeyekuti kana mwana asina kuenda kuchikoro haazi kuti ndoenda kupi ndoimwe challenge inenge iripo then tosvika pane vaivaya vane vari mentally challenge vaivaya idambudziko akabviswa ari munzira atozoti abviswa nani saka ichallenge zvakutoda mubereki kuti atofamba achichiona kuti chii chakaitika inenge tati adambudziko ndoimwe challenge iyeyo
We have socio-economic problems. For example, lack of money. They need transport money. Transport is quite expensive right now. They need transport money, take them to the clinic.
especially those with physical disabilities. They need wheelchairs, they need special transport with ramps to take them to the clinic to get whatever services that they might require. We also face, they have their own psychological issues, for example, the fear of judgment from the community, fear of judgment from the service providers, low self-esteem just by looking at your physical appearance. Some might feel that they are not worthy or they don't have the right, they don't look right enough or good enough or beautiful enough or handsome enough to access those services. Some of them have been physically abused, they have been emotionally abused, verbally abused. So you find that those people face challenges even to leave their own home, their own house, to go to the clinic or to go to the hospital to access any service that they might require. A disabled young person doesn't get the services that they might require. For example, in sexual reproductive health, you find that the STI might complicate if the person doesn't get treatment. You find they might get infected with HIV, and if they are not treated, you find we have unwanted pregnancies, we have long-term illnesses, immature deaths. You also find suicidal attempts can be on the rise. When somebody feels vulnerable and nobody else cares about them, they might wish to take their own life.
My role as a community leader is that to help in mobilization of the youth. As a council, I've got a register for the youth who are disabled. So when programs like youth games are organized, I'll help them to facilitate their attendance. Some youth may feel comfortable because as a counselor, I'm in touch with the youth in the community. So my presence will help them build their confidence. To ask patients if they've got problems that they want to mention even to the police, they'll feel comfortable because of my presence. Also, as a counselor, there are some issues the youth that can affect the youth, things to do with service delivery. So I'll be able to take them up to council so that they can be addressed. That's my role as a community leader.
So after carrying out the research, we discovered that many youths are facing a challenge in terms of accessing these services. And these challenges are mainly because of treatment that they are receiving when they go to these service providers, and also even the cost of paying for certain services that they would need. So we are appealing probably to the duty bearers who committed into providing these services to the youth, that they need to take into cognizance some of these problems that the youth are facing, that they may act so that things can be changed. Because we discover that if youth do not access these services, there are a lot of challenges that we might face. We might have unwanted pregnancies and even deaths, because some of these youths will start to carry out abortions, illegal abortions. So if these services are improved and if youths are encouraged to go and seek these services, it would improve the state of affairs for the youth in terms of their sexual and reproductive health. And also the access to this information will help to make them empowered, that they might know what their rights are, so that they do not fall into risky behavior or even get into dangerous situations which might lead to death.